Students, this is exercise 28, decimal fraction, question number 4. Now, question number 4 is more like how the way we have solved question number 3. There is a rope now. This rope is colored, okay? Different parts are colored. Now 0.215, there is one rope, so the total rope, how many are there? Only one, but its different portions are colored. 0.215 of the rope is red, so 0.215 is colored red. 0.145 colored green, so this much is colored green. Very colorful rope. And 0.34 is colored blue. And the remaining 60 meters is colored white. Now you can see that in decimal, how much portion is colored red, green and blue is given, but how much portion is white, that is not given to you in decimal. What is given? The length of the rope. If you measure the rope, the measurement of the rope is 60 meters and that much is white color. So first step, what we will do, we have to find the portion of the rope that is white colored. How will I find that? The total rope is 1. From there, I have to subtract the portion colored blue, green and red. So the total of this, if I subtract from 1, I will get the fraction which is white colored. So first we have to find portion, total portion of rope colored red, green and blue. That is equal to how much? 0.215 plus 0.145 plus 0.34. Now here you can see that only in the third value it is 0.34. So the number of decimal places in all the cases is 3. After decimal point there are 3 digits. So here we will make the 3 digit by adding 0. And now if you add the 3 values, you will get the total portion which is colored red, green and blue. So 0.700 is the total portion that is colored with the 3 colors. Now from the total one rope, if I subtract 0.700, I will get the fraction covered with white color. So portion, therefore portion of rope colored white equal to total minus 0.700. Now how will you subtract? 1 is the whole number given, so 1, it has got no decimal parts. Then write the second number, it has got only decimal parts, 0.700. So in order to make the decimal part equal, there are 3 digits. So after 1, I am placing a decimal point and adding 3 zeros. And here there is no whole number part. So you again, so this is balance you have to do first before solving. Now if you simply subtract, you will get 0.300. So this is the portion which is colored white. Now after knowing the portion that is colored white, 0.300, we also know if this is the portion colored white, and we also know the length of that portion is 60 meters. So 0.300 is the portion that is white colored, and that is equal to the length, whichever is of the rope, which is white colored. So now we will write. So according to the problem, 0.300 is colored red, sorry, colored white, and that is equal to how much? The length of the rope that is colored white, 60 meters. So now first from the decimal you have to convert this line only in normal fraction, that is numerator and denominator. So 0.300 means 300 by the denominator part, how will you write? Instead of point, write 1, 3 places, so 3 zeros is colored white, that is equal to 60 meters. Now this you can reduce to lowest term over here, because zeros, both the zeros and here can be cancelled. So it is 0.300 is nothing but 3/10. So this much portion is colored white, and that is equal to a length of 60 meters. Find the length of the rope. So total length of rope will be more or less. So from the idea you should know, if 60 meters is only white, the entire rope will be more length, because so many colors are put and the entire rope is much bigger. Only the portion of the long rope colored white is 60 meters. The total rope will be more, so obviously more than 60 meters. So whatever value is given, the length, you have to multiply. Since the total length will be more, so with the given length you have to multiply a greater than fraction. So 3/10 is a lesser than fraction. Convert into reciprocal to make it greater than fraction, and you just multiply. 3 to the 6, 0, so 20 into 10, 200 meter. Now students, one thing I will tell you, till now whatever sums we have done, the last step is coming same, that is the required value is more, so we are multiplying with a greater than fraction. But if greater value is provided, and suppose your required value should be less, so required value, if it is less, you have to multiply with a lesser than fraction. That means that time you have to change the fraction in such a way that the numerator is smaller. So sum number 4 is over here.